Previous video student, we have studied about meaning of systematics and taxonomy. Now we are going to understand what is taxonomic hierarchy. Taxonomic hierarchy is a position given to the organism in biology. Before we understand the positions present in taxonomic hierarchy, we need to know two terms, that is taxon and category. Now, what is taxon? Taxon is a group of organisms which forms concrete unit in classification. Again, I am repeating, taxon is a group of organisms which forms concrete unit in classification. So what is category now? Category is the rank or the position given to the organism. Now let's compare taxonomic hierarchy with the position present in your college. Which is the topmost position in college? That is trustee of the college. After trustee comes the director, next comes the principal, then vice principal, followed by HODs, then teachers, then comes the learner staff. Learner staff means students. Now, the position which I said, that is principal, vice principal, HOD, that position is category. And the person who is sitting on that position is called as taxon. I hope you understood the difference. Now, what are the such positions present in taxonomic hierarchy? Speaking about taxonomic hierarchy, these are the positions from top to down present in taxonomic hierarchy. The top position is kingdom. Next comes phylum or division. Phylum word is used for animals and division word is used for plants. Followed by class, then order, then family, genus and species. Now student, we have to understand meaning of each category. Now there is two options left with you. One, by heart all categories individually, or the another thing you can do is by heart the sequence and the first six definition becomes easy for you. How? I will explain you. Speaking about genus, a genus is defined as group of closely related species. Family is defined as group of closely related genus. Order is defined as group of closely related family and so on. So these are the categories in taxonomic hierarchy and they are defined on the basis of closeness shown by the lower category to form the upper category. Now we are going to study each category in detail. Now what is a basic unit of college? Basic unit of college is students, or you can say any educational system. The basic unit is student. Without student, no institute is possible. Similarly, over here in taxonomic hierarchy, species is a basic unit. It means without species, the upper categories cannot be formed. So let's understand one by one from below, that is our basic unit and other category in detail. First, species. Speaking about species, what is called as species or who is called as species? Species are group of organisms which fulfill two conditions. One, they have similar external features. For example, in case of human being, two eyes, one nose, lips, two ears. These are the similar external features shown by every human being. And second condition is they should be able to interbreed among themselves. It means they should have the ability to reproduce. So what is species? Group of organisms have external features, similar external features, and able to interbreed among themselves. Now student, there are few examples of organisms which are present among us, but they are not called as species. Why they are not called as species? Because out of these two conditions, anyone they must have not able to fulfill. If they are able to fulfill both the conditions, then they are called as species. So let's see examples of who are not a species. There are many examples, student. One, Zenki. Next, mule. Speaking about next example, Trigon. Plant, in case of plant, there is pomato, etc. So these are the few examples of not a species. There are many more. Next we are going to study what is meaning of genus. Genus is group of closely related species. There are two types of genus, monotypic and polytypic. Monotypic genus means the genus will have only one species, and polytypic means the genus will have many species. Now, what are the examples of monotypic and polytypic genus? Speaking about monotypic genus, there is one example called as Urtica dioica. Urtica is a genus under which there is only one species, that is dioica. Now, what is the common name of Urtica dioica? It is called as stinging plant. Stinging means the plant which stings, bites. Next, speaking about examples of polytypic genus. The example is Panthera. Under Panthera, there are various species. First, Tigris, that is tiger. Second, Leo, that is lion. Then comes the Pardus, that is leopard. Onca, jaguar. Next, we are going to study the category called family. What is family? Family is group of closely related genus. The example of family is Felidae family. Felidae family means cat family. It includes genus Felis and Panthera. Felis is a genus for cat and Panthera is a genus for tiger, lion, leopard, jaguar, etc. Next category is order. What is order? Group of closely related families forms order. The example of order is Carnivora. Under Carnivora comes two families. One is Felidae, that is cat family, and second is Canidae, that is dog family. The next category above order is class. The next category, student, above order is class. What is class? Class is a group of closely related orders. The example of class is mammals. Under mammals comes rodentia, that is rats, marsupials, that is kangaroos, chiroptera, that is bats, etc. The next category which we are going to study, student, is phylum. It is above class. What is phylum? Phylum is group of closely related class. What is the example of phylum? The example of phylum is Chordata. Chordata includes class mammals, apes, reptilia, pisces, etc. The topmost category is kingdom. Kingdom is a group of closely related phylum in case of animals, and it is a group of closely related divisions in case of plants. The example of kingdom is kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia consists of two phylum, Chordata and non-Chordata. Here we completed with taxonomic hierarchy. Thank you very much, student. We continue with the next topic in the next video.